So you want to know how I feel about Asian hate? I'll tell you how I feel about Asian hate. I'm headed downtown right now, Chicago. So here's the highway. And we're passing up the west side of Chicago. Many of you guys know the west side of Chicago here. By the way, I'm in a truck right now with a black man. What's up, Curtis? With a Mexican man. Say, what's up, Ivan?
What's up?
And yours truly, which is Filipino. Look at the three of us. Here's how I feel about Asian hate. Here's how I feel about hate in general. And the reason why I bring up this neighborhood, because the west side of Chicago, south side of Chicago, lots of times people across the country, they consider Chicago Chi-Raq for what happens. But sadly, it's gang violence around here, lack of gun control, and obviously splintered with hate and a lack of respect for human life. And based on what we saw in the news, what happened in Atlanta with the Asian massage parlor shooting, and people having different thoughts about hate, regardless of what race, creed, ethnic, religion you are, here's how I feel about hate in general. It's not about how I feel about Asian hate, especially people thinking, well, Matt, what's your opinion about, because you're Filipino. It's not about Asian hate. It's just hate, period. The fact that you think that to solve your problems, to make yourself feel better, to prop yourself up, it's a hate on other people. In Chicago, being known as one of the most racially segregated big cities in America, I grew up with this stuff. We are right here. We're headed to downtown Chicago. We just passed up Cicero. This is the west side of Chicago we're driving through right now. We're headed to the south shore of Chicago. Me being Asian, being Filipino, in a room or in a truck filled of multicultural diversity. If there's something to hate, it's to hate hate. And so it goes back to what type of life you want to live. What type of existence, what type of expectation do you have of yourself? What type of family do you want to raise? What type of community do you want to live in? What type of neighbors do you want? I got to go back to scripture. I got to go back to the things that I believe in. You may not believe in it, but here's at least some moral values and principles at least I can rest on, because I know I can't lean on me just being good enough to be a good person. You ever hear somebody says, well, I'm just going to be a good person? You know, Curtis and I were just talking about this the other day. Are you really wired to be a good person? Are you and I really wired to be good people? Are we? Think about this real quick. Are we? Are you? I've got 5 kids. Curtis, how many kids you got?
3.
3 kids. 0. Long time for him to have kids. I go to our friends in the Pacific Northwest, Polynesian culture. Average family size, 5, 6, 7 kids. Latino families, 3, 4, 5 kids. And I know that by raising children from birth, from babies, being a single dad at one point, 14 years being a single father before I married my now wife, the last 6, 7 years, I know that children, by default, aren't good. They're selfish, self-centered. Because of the lack of communication, they don't know how to communicate. What do? They cry. And what happens when that's corrected when you're a child? What happens when you get older and you can't communicate and you're yet unclear in how to process your own feelings? You cry. Cry different ways as an adult. I mean, to cry as a baby, you'll cry differently as an adult. And so when I look at the morals and values and principles of a faith, now you may not be a Christian. Some of you may not be Muslim. Some of you may not be Jewish. Some, whatever it is, I've got to find personally for myself, serving in the Marines, seeing the world for what it is, across the world, conflict, 2 combat tours. If there's something to hate, it's to hate hate. And there's a lot of freedom in these 2 words when you're feeling that type of hate. 2 words. You want to know what these 2 words are? Number 1 is forgiveness. Oh man, what a powerful word that is. Forgiveness. Like, who are you to think that you can't forgive other people that as if you have crap that don't stink? Like, you don't make mistakes. You don't think you make mistakes? I make a lot of mistakes. There's a lot of people I know that make a lot of mistakes. And if you care to use the word forgiveness, which I remember hearing Nelson Mandela use a lot after being in prison for 25 plus years, but yet he's still coming out of prison saying, forgive. Even though it took away a good portion of his life, he still came out saying, forgive. He says, forgiveness is a very, very powerful weapon. It frees, which leads me to the second word. Another freeing word is the word love. You know, it's, man, how can you say love? You know, one of the things I've experienced a lot in my life is conflict. And when I realized that if I am at least in a position of having courage to face those I have conflict with and process those thoughts, even though we may not agree, and we agreed to say, okay, you're going to stay on that position, I'm going to stay in this position, but we're still going to agree to find a way to get along. We're either going to still find a way to make money together, we're still going to find a way to run a company together, we're still going to find a way to run our family together. Even though we agree that we disagree on many different terms, guess what? I still love you as a human being. I still love you for what you stand for, because you got goals, you got dreams, just as much as I got goals and I got dreams. And I don't want to think that I'm any better than you. That in order for me to have creative dialogue and ongoing dialogue doesn't mean necessarily that you should shut down. That's love. And so what's my thoughts on Asian hate? What's my thoughts on Latino hate, Black hate, hate? If there's something to hate, it's to hate that. Because when there is hate, there's a lack of what? Love, forgiveness. And it's also, let me introduce a third word. You want to hear this third word? You may not want to hear this word. You may have never heard of it. You know what it is? It's called grace. It's called grace. And what is grace? Giving people love and forgiveness, even though they don't even deserve it. Listen, I have a savior in my life. You may not have a savior in your life. I have a savior in my life, and it's my faith. You may call your savior differently. I call my savior differently. And guess what? It's okay. I'm not judging you on you. You do you. We're going to do me in terms of who I call savior. And this savior gave me grace. Gave me love. Gave me forgiveness well beyond what I deserve in my life. And if my savior can do this for me, who am I not to pass this forward and pay it forward to somebody else, especially for those who don't deserve it? Think about the internal strength of what it takes to express love, forgiveness, and grace for those that despise you, even for those that hate you, even for those that don't respect you. Imagine if you start expressing those things and you and I start getting along better as human beings. Imagine what that would be like. Imagine what our world would be like. Republican, Democrat, independent, Jewish, Muslim, Christian, no matter what, you know, left, white, doesn't matter. Imagine you start expressing these three things. These morals, these values, these principles will ruin or build your life if you either have it or you don't have it. So your choice. Whatever you want to do, figure out what those can mean in your life. So anyway, that's my thoughts. For all my Asian brothers and sisters out there hurt by this incident, this most recent incident, I'm praying for you. I know it's not easy. And as much as it's so hard for you to consider these three words here right now, imagine if you can express that in your current life. And for everybody that feels marginalized, looked down upon, prejudiced and biased, imagine you can start expressing these things. Because here's one thing that I'm so glad Uncle Sam taught me when I was in the Marine Corps, and especially growing up in a neighborhood. Look at Chicago here, right? It's going through construction. If this big city can go through construction, what about you as a human being? But one thing I'm glad that the military ingrained in us was this thing. We never looked at color. They said either you're light green or you're dark green. Either way, you're my brother, you're my sister. You might be a darker shade than me, a lighter shade than me, but either way, you're one color. You're one color of green, one shade of green. Imagine if you and I can start looking at people that way. I don't care if you're white, black, brown, yellow, purple. I can look at you not as a separate race, but look at you as one race, and that's the human race. That being said, guys, let me know your thoughts, your comments. Put them down below. You agree with me, don't agree with me. And if you would love to share this with somebody that you want to express and help express in their life love, forgiveness, and grace, please share this with them. Tag them and let them know. The Money Smart Guy here in the city of Chicago hopefully is doing my part to spread not a message of hate, of pointing fingers, but say, you know what, in this position, listen, I've lost people in my life too as well. Don't think that I'm above this. But imagine if we continue on with love, forgiveness, and grace, how much better we'd be, embrace the human race, how much better you and I would be in this country. That being said, guys, I'm a Money Smart Guy. Until we meet again, continue to live smart, and be money smart today. God bless you guys. Bye-bye.